there, Foxy Gamers! Welcome back to Subnautica! Let's take a right turn this time on the Aurora. Oh, by the way, last episode, right after- whoops, almost had some debris falling on me. I guess it's not hurting me much. I picked up a data thingy, but it didn't have a code on it. It just had- oh gosh, I don't even remember which one it was now, actually, so never mind. Anyway, it didn't have anything particularly important on it, but we do need to get through this fire, so I'll use what's left of this fire extinguisher first, and I picked up another one that was back a little ways. Da-da-da. And that is all of our fire extinguishers. Oh, good thing I picked up the other one. Okay, I don't think I need to put it out over there, because there's nothing to find, so might as well not waste it. Essential life things! Let's check this one out. Kim's birthday, my birthday. Weeks still before we get home. 400 weeks it feels like we before we get home. Credits I'm doing for this. Cargo bay code. Well, there you go. Thank you very much. What else do we have? Altera launches the Aurora. Phase gate announced for the Ariadne arm. Altera launches the Aurora. The furthest reaches of inhabited space are due to expand. It should be farthest, by the way. Just saying. As Altera Core launches a newly constructed capital ship, carrying a phase gate bound for the Ariadne arm. The Aurora will travel from space dock on the edge of Altera space, making hundreds of consecutive phase gate jumps through 9 different transgov authorities, and arrive on the far side of the Ariadne arm in 3 months' time. From there, the command crew will pilot the ship beyond the final phase gate, arriving in the next solar system approximately 18 months later. There, the elite team of engineers will begin a 6-month construction project on the new phase gate, a multi-trillion credit investment. In the absence of existing infrastructure in the region, the vessel is equipped with advanced thermal and nuclear power facilities. Altera Core currently operates 9% of all phase gates in the galaxy. If the Aurora's mission is successful, Altera will have outmaneuvered a cabal of Mongolian corporations, operating a range of outposts and mines in the region. Well, looks like it's gonna take you guys more than 18 months, huh? We already have the trash can blueprint, apparently. Is there anything else at all back here for us? No. Was there- ah, yes, there is a poster on the wall, which I would like. Oh, I guess I just pick it up. For some reason, I thought I was supposed to scan that, but I guess not. I'm gonna take care of our thirst real quick. I guess not hunger, because that's plus 75, so we don't need that just yet. Alright, well let's go take advantage of this cargo bay code. Whoopsies. Trying not to get hit by all the falling debris. Okay, I don't remember what it was. 1454. Do not know why it sounds like we're jumping in and out of the water, but, you know, game is early access, so. Oh, it's not the water, it's these things dropping fire. Okay, that's cool. Don't remember if there's fall damage or not. Well, let's find out. This is a good time to find out. Oh, yep, okay. There is fall damage, and that was actually a lot more fall damage than I was expecting. Well, it's good to know that we found that out in a fairly safe place. I do believe there are things to scan around here, but I can't remember. Alright, never mind. There is nothing scannable in this area. Alright, let's make sure we don't get hit by this crap. Run! Oh god. What we have in here? Nutrient block, okay. Don't mind if I do. As far as I know, there is no other way to get nutrient blocks in this game. You cannot craft them, so once you're out, you're out. Are there bleeders? Does not appear to be any in here. I know they're in the radiation room, unless something has changed. I am not looking forward to that, because bleeders are fucking obnoxious. Why does it sound like there's a Reaper in here? That's not cool. Drive room. Drive core shielding, sustain moderate internal damage during collision. Do not attempt to repair without appropriate qualifications. Yeah, so that is our area. I'm gonna wait on that. Yes, indeed, there are bleeders. There is one right now. Fuck you. I am not dealing with you at the moment. Okay, there's none right here. So we'll go ahead and cut our way through. Woohoo! Well, at least there are plenty of medical kits for us to deal with the bleeders. I can't remember how much damage they actually do to us. If they don't do a huge amount of damage, I might just deal with them latching onto me for a bit, because it's really hard to avoid them. Are there any in here before I stop to read this? Okay. Looks like we're safe. Alright, let's check out what that data entry says. Ooh, Degassi survivors. Aurora auxiliary mission, search and rescue, crew of the Mongolian vessel Degassi. Ariadne Arm, contact emissary Jochi Kassar. Mission brief, a Mongolian vessel, the Degassi, disappeared almost a decade ago. Corporate insurance has purchased passage aboard the Aurora for emissary Kassar, and your orders are to afford them every reasonable facility to locate and, if appropriate, retrieve the Degassi crew members without compromising the primary mission. The Aurora is due to perform a gravity slingshot maneuver around planet 4546B approximately 13 months post-launch. This will bring the ship within range of the Degassi's last known position. Degassi crew manifesto has been distributed to senior employees in a separate data package. Okay. Oh, here's another PDA. Let's check out this one. Sweet offer. You're telling me these last 13 months you never took a ride on the outside? Well, now you've got yourself an insider in robotics. We've plain got nothing to do until we get starside and start work on the gate. You want to get hands-on with a mech and taste the stars, you've only got to say. I've got a righteous prawn suit here with your name on it. You don't know what power feels like until you've crushed an asteroid with your bare, heavily mechanically augmented hands. If you're up for it, come by my living quarters. Code is 1869. Awesome. Okay. Oop. Battery? Nope. I am so over batteries. But I am going to eat a nutrient block. And drink some water. Awesome. Well, guys, if we ever need more batteries, we know where to go. Da-da-da. Alright, I think, let's see, we gotta put out this fire, and, this is another good reason we had a repair tool before we came here. There we go. Hooray! The prawn suit bay! Oh, goodness. I will take all the power cells I can get, as a matter of fact. Can I scan these without getting burned and without having to put out the fire? I would like to not have to waste my fire extinguisher, if at all possible. I find it very strange that an entire prawn suit is laying there, but it's only considered a fragment. Erg. Yeah, we might have to put out the fire. Let's see. Maybe we can get these guys up here. Can I reach it? Yeah. Nope, guess not. Alright, fine, we'll put out the fire. Unless, can we move this with the propulsion cannon? Eh? Eh? Nope, okay, fine. Oh, you gotta be kidding. Okay, phew! I was gonna say, that would be not very cool. Alright, there's our prawn suit. I believe we can also get the moon pool in the Aurora? I can't remember. Damn, I do not remember there being this many power cells before. Okay, we're definitely running out of inventory space, but I can drop that guy. Goodness gracious. Alright, now we will use the propulsion cannon. Ka-choo! I guess this is why there's so many batteries lying around. Yep. Come on! Oh, fine. Be a jerk. Ka-choo! Oh, that is so fun. No! Not you! Come on! Come on! There we go. I don't know what the, you know, the way it works with targeting those things. I'm not sure the mechanics behind that, but oh, woo! A bar table. All right. Ah, kitty poster! Yay! So exciting. Somehow I missed that the last time I was on the Aurora. Oh boy, I hope I have enough of the fire extinguisher. Oh my gosh, so much water. Wow, that is a lot of water. Man, they have definitely added a lot of stuff. What happens if I just, if I drop it, will it just stay here? Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the lab equipment behind because I'm not entirely sure that's anything beyond cosmetic, and we definitely have some of that already. I don't have a terrible amount of fire extinguisher left, so I hope, maybe we can just squeeze around here. Woo! We can scan a vending machine? That's awesome! Sweet! Totally putting a vending machine in our base, guys. Woo! Oh, wow! There's a ton more scannable stuff in here than there used to be. Lab counter, maybe that will help us out with, making use of the lab equipment, I don't know. Ah, there's another fire extinguisher, yay! Okay, what does this data download say? Doo-doo-doo. Technical. Vehicles. PRAWN. The suit is fully insulated from the outside environment. Powerful hydraulic limbs allow for manipulation of objects and powered traversal of the environment. Rear-mounted thrusters provide maneuverability in low-gravity environments. A range of modifications are available to facilitate resource extraction and enhanced exploration. Reactive waterproof nanosuit. Yay! Kitty poster! So excited. I don't see anything of importance back there. Can't get in that door, so I believe we are done here. Wow, this is, I definitely don't remember any of this. It must have been expanded. Ooh, a bed! Fantastic! Yeah, so I don't know if I just didn't make it up this way because I didn't have a propulsion cannon and maybe that was the only entrance to this area? I'm not sure. Or if it actually just did get a ton of stuff added to it. Ah! I can't carry all this stuff. So sad. Do I? I don't think I need another poster, right? I already got that one. I'm gonna leave it there then. Oh yes, that's right. Now bags actually serve a purpose as well. Instead of just being cosmetic, but I don't have room for it, so it's just, oh. Okay, that was odd. Those are just gonna stay there for now. Oh no, another door code. Ah, do we have this one? Let's see, I think we have three, right? 1869. I think maybe that's the one we haven't used. Don't know if that's right. Nope! Bugger! Let's see if it's anywhere else. I don't think it is, because I think it would show up under the codes if we had it. I'm gonna glance around one more time just to look for this code. Oh, geez, there's more codes. Ah! There we go, that one is 1869. Maybe we'll find the other code in here! Responsible autonomous relationships. Nope, not a code, but let's check it out. Wait, where'd it go? Hello? I guess that didn't give us anything. Okay, fine. Another bed! Ah! A cap? That's silly. Okay. Oh, a stuffed animal! I have to have that! Okay. We've gotta clear up our inventory space now. Oh boy. I definitely want to keep all these power cells, but, you know, let's just drop all the batteries that are low, and we can pick them up another time if we feel like it. Yay! Arcade Gorge toy! Aw, that's cute. Alrighty, moving on. Oh, here's a data. Relationship contract, legal recording. Ooh, it's Wilson again. Listen, I know I don't have the right to make demands of you, but I need you to understand that I want to change our relationship. I hear what you're saying, and I will try to respect it. How would you like to change it? I would like to reduce our contact hours. How much further can we do that? 2-0. You're dumping me? I'm changing the terms of our relationship. Is it still a relationship if we don't see each other? Of a kind. You have so many expectations. I feel you just want to spend more time with those guys on the leisure deck. I feel hostility in what you're saying, and that jealousy is a possessive emotion. Why can't you be happy for me? I am happy for you, and I'm happy for the guys on the leisure deck. I'm just not happy for me. This is why I want to change our relationship. Oh, okay. Pretty much sounds like breaking up to me. Is that really all there is in here? Another poster. So many decisions on what I want to take with me. Alright, I drank some water to clear up some space. Can't open any of those, okay. What's behind this door? Ow, whoops! Got a little ahead of myself! Ah! Missed some. Huzzah! Transgov profile, Altericore. One of the largest suppliers of spacefaring technologies and consumer electronics in the Federation, the official supplier of the TSF, consistently ranked amongst the galaxy's best employers, began life as a defense manufacturer in the mid-22nd century. So that gives you sort of an idea of where we're at. National motto slogan, get what you deserve. Although most transgovs can trace their roots back to Earth, Altera, literally meaning by Earth, is the only one brazen enough to take its name. Uh-oh, is the fire coming back? No, okay. During the expansion, Altera supplied arms to all sides, acquiring and housing a vast colonist workforce and making the transition from manufacturer to state. The corporation's threat to seize trade was one of the turning points in the conflict, bringing about the end of hostilities and the signing of the charter. Altera holds the monopoly within its own borders. Free enterprise is encouraged, but competition is tight. All goods exported off-world must be Altera-branded, and profitable businesses are brought out by the state. Owners ascending to the Altera Board of Directors. Well-known Altera technologies such as the Cyclops submersible originated with such private enterprise. Despite superficial similarities to national governments, the corporation's lawyers have always maintained that it has no legal obligation to its employees, but voluntarily elects to take on the roles usually served by a democratically elected government. This claim has not yet been tested in the Federation courts. But still no door code for the other secret door. I'm not sure I really care about picking up that backpack, so I'm just gonna leave it there for now. Alright, guys, looks like that's all there is to see up there. You know, I'm gonna take one of these first aid kits just because I can. Does not appear to be anything else of interest down here. Oh, get out, come on. Game is hard. Alright. What is that? Ooh, what is that? I don't even know. I'm gonna drop something to find out, though. Drop another battery, I guess. What are you? Come on. Storage module! Ooh, yay! So exciting. Okay, now I feel like I've gotta check out what else is up here, if anything. Okay, I guess we'll... Do we want to give the radiation room a try? I don't know. You guys tell me, if you think it's worth closing off all the open spots of the radiation room, I will do it, but I'm not- whoop, what was that? There was something scannable. Where'd it go? Ah, there's- oh, it's a fucking bleeder, that's what it is! Alright, fine, let's find out how much damage these guys do to me. Come here! Latch on! Come here! Hey, buddy! Alright. Okay, it's not super friendly. Not super friendly. Did I kill you? Okay. Well, we might as well scan you. Actually, maybe I won't, because that's like kind of a nice warning to me. Damn! Okay, those guys are pretty shitty. That was some fast damage. Yeah. I don't think... I feel- oh god! Fuck! There's another one! Jesus Christ! God. Oh! Jesus! They're all over the fucking place. Seamoth Bay. That's where we wanna go. Alright, well, we gotta repair this. And we're probably gonna get latched onto again. So yeah, if- fuckity fuck. Damn, well, if I get, like, where are they? Are there any more in here? I'm not gonna deal with the radiation room right now. Ah! God damn it, come here! Oh, shit! Oh, God, that's bad. That's super bad. Okay. So, I just used up our knife. And I'm not sure there's any way. Why am I still swimming? Oh god. I'm not sure there's any way to get bleeders off of us. Oh shit. Without without a knife. Fuckity fuck, man. Alright, well, I'll repair these leaks that are easy to get to. But I dare not even attempt to close the other ones. Whoop. Cyclops module, cool. I'm not even gonna try the others when if I don't have a knife. God, I guess I used up the entire durability killing those stupid little guys outside. Okay, well... I guess that kind of concludes our trip to the Aurora, guys. I'd maybe be... No, I wouldn't even want to attempt taking those guys on if I wasn't playing permadeath, because... Ah, fuck. I'd still lose all the shit that I picked up, and I got a ton of power cells. Oh god, but now how do I get out of here without encountering them? Shit. This could be really bad. I don't remember how I got in here. Alright, well, one key to keeping the bleeders from latching on is to swim fast. So, hopefully... if I just keep moving... oh, God! Woo! So many things. Oh, boy. Alright. Well, I think that's it for now. I can always come back here if, you guys tell me I missed something that's very important, or if you can give me a good reason why I should stop the radiation leak, then by all means, let me know. Otherwise, for now, I think it's just a convenience factor, of which I'm not terribly concerned about. Alright, I kind of want to leave behind these fire hydrants, but they might actually roll off of this. I'm not entirely sure. I saw a battery rolling by me a minute ago, so maybe I'll go back up to the door here. Shit, I don't know. Maybe I'll leave them right here and hope they don't despawn. You guys gonna stay there? Yes, hopefully. Okay. Well, worst case scenario, I do believe we can craft fire hydrants. That would not be very convenient to have to go back to our base, craft one, and then come back. But I'm gonna take that chance right now. Alright. Well, so long as we don't encounter any Reapers... ah, there's a lot of those buggers hanging out here. Jeez! Get out of here! Back off! I think it was mostly a successful trip. But yeah, definitely sneaking out the side here in order to minimize the chances of running into a Reaper. Let's take a quick look behind us. Okay, don't see any, don't hear any. That is positive. Uh-oh, game freezing. Okay, more stuff down here, but my inventory is full. What do we have down here? I can't remember if there was anything special. Looks like just salt. Alright. Oh! Energy Pulse Origin. Looks like we picked up something from one of our PDAs, so we will have to go check that out next. But it does look like that's all we have for today, so thanks a lot for watching, boys and berries, and until next time, stay foxy.